Hi everyone. So today I'm going to take you through a few options for the Galaxy S6 and S6 Edge. Now this is going to center around really fixing the storage problems that a lot of people are potentially going to have with the Galaxy S6 because it doesn't have a micro SD card slot. There is no expandable storage here. Essentially, the memory that we have in the device, 32, 64 or 128, is all we have to work with. But what can we do to kind of make things a bit easier for ourselves? Well, the Galaxy S6 has a few options available to it. For starters, what you may not be aware of is that you were given 100 gig of additional storage space in the cloud from Microsoft. Now this is OneDrive. All you need to do is get your Galaxy S6, open OneDrive and log in. Simple as that. That will gain you 100 gig of additional storage and you can use that for absolutely anything. For instance, uploading your images or movie files that you've recorded on your Galaxy S6, storing any documents that you may have created, and so on. This will allow you to get the files off your device and into the cloud to be recalled whenever you have Wi-Fi or an internet signal, effectively. It's a small thing, but it's an option that's there for you, and it's well worth taking advantage of. If you're someone like me, takes an awful lot of pictures and videos, just getting those off the device as quickly as possible so you can sort them later on your PC or Mac is very, very handy. It essentially means you can shoot more photos and videos before you fill up your internal memory. Some other things to be aware of here. If you go into your settings area and come down to applications, you can see what applications you currently have installed, and you can then uninstall those from there if you want to. You can also see which ones are running. If you want to get a better idea as to where your storage is being used up on the device, you can come to the dedicated storage option. In here, you can actually see, based on categories, what is using up all of your space. Your system memory, that's non-negotiable, I'm afraid. That is the Android operating system. But the areas where we can look is into used space, where we can then see how much space applications are taking up, pictures and video, and audio. By using this, you can then go in and clean things out if you need to. But the really interesting thing that you're actually here in this video for is to find out how to expand the current internal storage that you have using some third-party options. Now, this works very, very simply. For instance, we have here a card reader from Inatek. This uses a micro USB cable. Very, very simple process. You can pick these up for around £15. Plug it into the bottom of your Galaxy S6 and it will immediately power on. Then all we need to do, install a memory card into it, or because this has USB ports as well, you could plug in an external hard drive here. You've also got options for memory stick also. And then straight away, it will power up the SD card and give you access to the files on there. For instance, on here, it's just an old drive I use for storing some music on from Google Music. But the point is fairly simple. Once you have your external memory card plugged in, you'll then be able to use the various features of Android to copy data across to the card. Personally, I would recommend downloading a tool like Astro. It's a much better file manager, in my opinion, than the one that comes with the Samsung Galaxy S. But it's as simple as that when it comes to quite literally grabbing your footage and dropping it across onto an SD card. And it's as simple as that. In doing so, you've literally expanded your external storage for the Galaxy S6, and all you need is this little adapter and a memory card. Sure, it's not as good as having a dedicated memory stick built into the actual Samsung Galaxy S6 that's removable, but at the end of the day, this is a workaround for you. For many people, including myself, I've been using these adapters for many years as a really simple way of quickly moving data from an Android smartphone onto a memory stick and then wherever it needs to be. But likewise, I can use this in reverse to store information onto here to then transfer quickly and easily onto the Galaxy S6. For instance, taking photographs directly from a DSLR to then edit on my phone or a tablet, whatever you need to do. The only thing you need to make sure of is that your Android device supports USB to go. That's what this adapter effectively is making use of here. That pretty much covers every Android device released over the last couple of years, but specifically on the Galaxy S6, it does allow us to expand the storage with minimal fuss and effort. So let me know in the comments what your top tips for saving space on the Samsung Galaxy S6 is. Have you come up with something easier than a little dongle and a memory card? Do let me know in the comments.